Welcome to the OAO Member Spotlight, your chance to get to know your colleagues in a new and engaging format. Each month, we highlight a member doing something unique and interesting, something you can take inspiration from, and maybe even implement into your own practice. Sit back and enjoy the OAO Member Spotlight.
Well, welcome back, everybody, to another OAO Member Spotlight. And today, it's my pleasure to introduce to you, and many of you probably know our special guest today, Dr. Howard Dolman. Welcome, Howard.
Thank you, Jeff.
Before we get going into the Member Spotlight, I understand that yesterday was a pretty special landmark optometry day for you. Do you know what I'm referring to?
Yes. 25 years that our class graduated, and we weren't able to celebrate in person, but we did start off firing an email to a few people, and that led to a few more. And before the end of the day, about 60% of the class had seen the email, which is pretty good considering email wasn't even on the horizon when we graduated 25 years ago. Well, it might have been on the horizon, but the far horizon.
So this was, you're a class of 1990 then, University of Waterloo, is that correct?
That is correct.
I've got a little, I found this photo of on the website. Do you recognize anybody on that picture, Howard?
I recognize everybody in that picture.
Point out to the listeners which one is you.
Sure, I'm third from the left. That's
There we go.
What you can't see in that picture is I'm actually wearing a t-shirt under my gown.
Ah, okay, very nice.
Yes, cheap. The t-shirt that it had a saying on it, which I thought was appropriate. The listeners can look it up. It's the Web Wilder Credo, not the internet web, but W-E-B-B, Web okay. Wilder Credo. You can look it up and see how it fits in.
Right. Okay. Well, I'll leave that to our viewers to look on the web to find out about the web.
Yes.
So class of 1990, University of Waterloo, and you've kind of come full circle. The reason we're having you on the Member Spotlight today, the reason we thought it'd be interesting to chat with you was because of you're now teaching a course at the University of Waterloo School of Optometry. So do you want to give us a little information about what that course is?
Yes, it's my pleasure. That course celebrated its 15th year as part of the University of Waterloo Optometry School program. And a lot of credit goes to Dr. Vince Timpano, who took the course from, you know, various informal notes and really put together a remarkable collection of items that are really important for students graduating to know. And just a sequence of events, Dr. Timpano was thinking about stepping away and pursuing other passions. And it came across to me through Dr. Spafford, Harley Spafford, who was interim director at the time of the School of Optometry, if I would be interested in taking over the course.
Okay, so is there anything to do with the OAO or the CAO? Are they involved in this course?
The course is sponsored by the CAO. And so I worked very carefully with Lori Clement, the CAO director, or the CAO executive director. And we put together a reboot this year. This past year was my first year teaching it, to put a little more emphasis on patient care and treating the patient as a customer.
So Howard, I think most people know you run a very, very successful practice with your wife, Kim. Now, just because you run a successful practice doesn't mean you can impart that knowledge on students. So what skills do you have? How are you able to impart your experience and share that with the students at U of W?
Yeah, that's a great question. And first and foremost, I'm myself a student of practice management teaching. Kim and I purchased an existing practice very early after graduating. I had only been in practice 4 years, Kim for two. And we really didn't have any background in practice management. It was sink or swim. And we sunk very quickly in our first year. And so we reached out to Liam's consulting group at the time. And they basically gave us an MBA in practice management. And then we spent a few years with the Kleinman Performance Network. And that's where I learned the power of peer group networking, how each optometrist can learn a lot of incredible things from each other. And from there, I've moved on to other peer groups, both in the United States and Canada. And that combined with the Chaos Mentor Program. Every year, we take a number of students into our office from the optometry school. And I learned that, you know, these students are really hungry for as much as they can get in terms of how to run a practice. And it was exciting to bring them in, even just one tour of the office and talk about the things that happen day to day that they could, you know, learn from. and build on. And so the combination of the Chaos Mentor program experience and my own experience through our practice and practice management made me very excited to take over the practice management course.
So how do you make the content practical for the students? I mean, at this stage in their student career, they're so focused on clinicals, they're so focused on just passing and getting their OD degree. How do you make this practical so that it sticks, so that when they get out into the real world, they're armed with some of this knowledge that you've gathered over 25 years of practice?
And that's the challenge. You know, how do you condense 25 years of experience into 24 hours of lecture material? And so I did my best to try to rearrange the material into key areas. And so starting with customer service, really changing the paradigm of how we approach, you know, patient care, much, much more from the customer service side. And then from there, teaching financial literacy, marketing, both internal and external, of course, HR and office operations. So by arranging the course material in those key areas, not only did I help them to see that the information is approachable, but hopefully they'll be able to go back on the course content and pick into those areas as they need them when they graduate. And then I sprinkled in some multimedia, showing videos, you know, to help highlight certain areas, and talked about real life occurrences. When things happened in our clinic, whether it was good or bad, I brought it to the students and I said, you know, these things are learning experiences. And so I think the students really appreciated, you know, the day-to-day things that occur in a practice and how they would be able to approach it once they graduated.
So what has surprised you the most? You probably walked into this course on day number one with a bunch of assumptions in your head, thinking, okay, this is how it's going to go. These are the questions they're going to ask. This is what I should teach them. Are there certain, can you share with us something that really caught you off guard that you weren't expecting?
Well, first of all, I wasn't expecting them to be so quiet. I thought either I'm putting them to sleep, or I'm going way over their head, or it just turned out that the course was first thing Monday morning, and you know, that's a quiet time for anybody, especially university students. So they warmed up after a while. I think the other thing that surprised me is that, you know, a good percentage of third year students really are thinking about that next step, even though it's still more than a year away. Their mind is already racing. Am I going to experience private practice as an associate? Am I going to be looking for a buy-in arrangement? Am I looking at a cold start? So even at the end of third year, they're already thinking those things, which kudos to them.
So can you see yourself in these students, you know, 25 years later? Are there certain commonalities that maybe questions that were running through your head in 1989 or 1990? Do you see some of those same questions 25 years later?
Oh, absolutely. You know, the patients who drive you crazy will never go away. The situations where you're wondering, where do I bend? Where do I draw the line? They never go away. You know, staff issues and financial issues that really, you know, the names change, that the challenges change, but the situations stay the same. And that's really why this course is so important. Because if you were to ask, you know, a third year student, you know, how relevant is this information? Hopefully there's enough in the course content that they're going to say, yeah, this is really key. When I graduate, I'm going to go back on this information, first of all. But second of all, I have connections now that I can make to help take me to the next level. So it's not just the course content. It's providing those next steps. Who do I connect with to take me onward in my practice journey?
Yeah, and that's that. I was just about to ask you that question. That's a great point, Howard. Once these kids hit the ground running, what support can we give, you know, from the OAO, for example, or from the buying groups? How do we support these students to help them make those first tentative steps?
And that's absolutely what we need to do. And that's why the LinkedIn forum that was created by the OAO and the practice management tools that have been created, both on the marketing side and also on the HR side, really are key. And I know that it's just the beginning, that there are more and more tools being developed by the OAO, you know, literally on a monthly basis. So kudos to the board of directors and to you, you know, in making those tools available.
Yeah, no, I think they're, you know, we've gone to the students and chatted with them every year in January. And there's just a thirst thirst for, you know, what's happening in the real world. They're just like sponges, and they soak everything up. So, you know, kudos to you, Howard, for, you know, taking on this course. You're a very busy guy. You run a very busy practice. You've got a family. I don't know how you find the time to do this, but it's a very important thing that you're doing. So thank you. Thank you very much. And I wish you all the best success going forward in this program.
Thank you, Jeff. And thank you to you again. You know, as president, you have a lot of plates spinning as well. And I think we all benefit. It just raises the bar of the profession. We all benefit from that, from the new grad or the not even yet in fourth year, going to fourth year student, all the way up to the seasoned professional looking at retirement. We benefit from all those tools, all the peer networking, all the things that are in place. Thank you.
No, they're our future, and you're giving them a great head start. So thanks, Howard. Thanks for sharing with the membership your story.
Thank you, Jeff.